Johnny Valentine, Johnny Valentine. He's a lover, not a fighter, they call him Johnny Valentine.
Hi and welcome back, it's Johnny Valentine. We're playing through Discworld, a Terry Pratchett novel at the implementation for the PC. This is actually Scum that I've downloaded, Scum VM, which allows you to play the game from modern computers. In the last episode we had a walkthrough and introduction to the game, and we managed to start off with the tasks. And the first thing we did is we got the staff off of one of the wizards and brought it back to the Arch-Chancellor, and now we need to go and get the other things needed, the other three things needed to build a device to track dragons. So let's carry on, walk out and see what's happening around the university. So not too sure where the exit is. There's the kitchen, there's the dining hall, library, closet, and there's the main door. So out through the main door into the garden. Okay, walking down the path of Unseen University, and we find an apprentice wizard sitting there. So let's have a chat with him, see what he has to say for himself.
How do you open the gate?
They've changed the wasp names. The hand wriggles. It's a whole new spell.
So show me the new spell.
Can't. The spell's a secret.
Mm. So let's when you play the game, you do get these choices. You can say goodbye. You can just talk to a
nice weather.
Since classes in wind whistling, rain making, and lightning throwing are all scheduled for today, I think that's being a wee bit premature.
Oh, and down comes the rain.
So, this is it. You just stand here all day getting a wage for eating prunes?
Certainly. Someone's got to do it. It's a plum job.
It's a plum job.
The hand wriggles, please.
Yeah, right. Look, you just wiggle them like this.
Like this.
Oops, that's what you call a rebound. Oh, this frog!
Yes, almost. Now try it like that.
Like this.
Right you are, son. Now, if you'll excuse me, I think I'd like a nice lie down.
But what about the gate? Aren't you going to guard it?
Oh, who gives a monkeys?
He said the M word.
Did you get the number of that donkey cart?
So let's
I'll catch you later then.
Pick up the frog. Put him in the luggage. Where's the luggage? Luggage is hiding from me.
That doesn't work.
Drop the frog in the luggage. Right, if we now follow the path round to the back side of the building. Oh, let's find some bags there. Bag of fertilizer, pick that up while we're here. Follow the building around. We should be able to come back out and now open the doors, because we've been shown how to open the doors. So let's go and visit Ankh-Morpork. Swift kick always helps. So here we are in Ankh-Morpork. A very familiar map. You, for those of you who know the books, palace, that'll be the Patrician's palace. So. Let's pop along there.
So, anyway, how's the wife?
Oh, not so bad. How's yours?
Oh, doing well, doing well. We thought we might invite you two around for dinner tomorrow night. I've made a chocolate cake, strawberry pudding, and duck's foot casserole with leaf mould. I've made a chocolate cake, strawberry pudding, and duck's foot casserole with leaf mould.
Leaf mould?
Oh, sorry. Did I say leaf mould? I meant caramel. Anyway, there'll be lashings of everything. You know the wife. She likes to cook.
Yeah, but is this a good idea? I thought she was watching her weight.
Why should she watch her weight?
Well, you know, after last time, when she accidentally ate that camel.
Oh, she's not overweight. She's just, she's just cuddly.
Yeah, cuddly. Very, very cuddly. With humps.
So,
humps.
How's your wife, then? Did she get that thing off her face?
Thing? What thing?
The hairy thing.
That's a beauty spot, that is.
Oh, I see. Bit long for a beauty spot, isn't it? No, I mean, in
see this guy.
Look, moustaches are supposed to be a sign of sensuality.
What, on women?
Listen, are you calling my wife ugly?
No.
Good. I'd have been ever so cross if you did.
So they sound to me like John Pertwee and Tony Robinson. Don't know what you think, but let's talk to one of them. You can just
Look,
say hello.
Could you just let me in, please?
Clear off!
Now, that's what I call a guarded conversation.
Ha, ha, ha. So let's ask him a
is
question.
Is she really that fat, then?
What?
Well, your friend was saying how fat your wife is, so I thought...
Oh, he did he?
Lies. I'll never...
And that's how we get into the palace. Because.
Well, I'll just move along, then, shall I? Fine.
It's not guarded.
Well, I'll just move along, then.
Well, make the hand appear, and we can walk past, because there's no guard there. What have we got in here? Let's have a look. Oh, there's a queue with a witch and a thief. There's a door. Oh, and there's someone else there. Who's there? Peasant. Chucky the Joker. And there's the patrician. Let's say hello to the patrician, shall we? See if we can talk to him.
So, I hope you've come here on pleasant business.
Yeah, well.
Non-disruptive business. Reliable. Solid business. Rather than mere disruptive rumour-mongering. Would I be right?
Oh, that's a dragon. Let's ask about
serious
the dragon.
Serious business. Well, yes.
Really?
Oh,
what?
Well, that is...
Now listen to me. There are no such things as dragons. They are a physical impossibility. No ifs, buts, or maybes. I've had enough. The next person who mentions dragons in my presence will be off for a trip to the information gathering technicians. Extremely quickly.
Well, I just thought...
Yeah?
Oh, right you are then.
He didn't say don't
Look,
let me
I'll
detain
you. I'll
just go
and stand over here then, all right?
So, let's go through this door. In the door. Oh, it's a bathroom. If we walk way along, there is a little mirror. And we'll need that later. Take that, put that in the luggage. This is what the patrician's bathroom looks like.
That doesn't work.
Can't do anything with the bathroom at the moment, so let's just leave. So, we can talk to people if you like. Let's talk to one of the witches.
Hello, dear.
Eek!
Tired? Ooh, I give a pretty good foot massage.
Now let's remain very... very calm about this, shall we?
A quiet dinner, a relaxing evening watching the potions brew. I'm very good at toes, you know. How's about just a little sing-song? Don't suppose you know a wizard's staff has a knob on the end, do you?
Mine hasn't, I can assure you. But I'll just rush off and check, just in case.
There's a joke in there somewhere about a wizard's staff having a knob on the end. It is a long-running joke in the series. So, let's leave the palace. The guard's still on the floor. Work our way out. Back onto the streets. There's the palace. There's the square. There's a street. So let's go into the street. And there's a toy shop. We go in the toy shop. So usually when you're playing this game, you would... just wander around and find these things out for yourself. I'm doing things in a certain order. a toy maker who looks
Greetings, good, shopkeeper!
Like
good day, sir. Can I interest you in our toys? There's today's special, an amusing line of bells and whistles. Or there's Violent Bob, the doll with a face you can rip clean off.
Eh?
It's very therapeutic.
I'm sure.
The sort of thing you can share with your brothers. Brothers of evil, walking arm in arm across the rooftops of the world.
Are you all right?
Pardon? Oh, yes, yes. Never felt better. So, can I help you at all, sir? Anything special catch your eye?
Oh, just browsing.
Browsing?
Yes.
Not plotting?
Definitely not.
Not secretly planning the overthrow of the patrician and the total dominance of the city?
No, not at all.
Oh, damn. Right you are, sir. Browse away.
You can say it's quite an old game, especially with the casual racism of the German accent, talking about taking over the city and things. Still, there you go. So we'll take one of these little pink donkeys with us. Nice Hogfather toy, and we'll take the string. Let's grab the string, put that inside the luggage as well. And we'll carry on working our way down the street. Now, down the street, we should be able to find a fish merchant. So let's carry on walking down the Ankh-Morpork Pork streets. Oh, I seem to have got caught behind the luggage. That's not good, is it? So I can sneak past him there. Yeah. There's a corner. No other shops there. So let's go down to the corner. There's someone there. Oh.
And verily shall he bellow forth the 10 sacred names of the Forbidden Dawn. I tell a lie, the 9 sacred names of the Forbidden Dawn. Then shall he stride forth, and many shall be the number of his stridings. Full across the disc shall he stride, and those who gaze upon him shall say, Look, it is Offler, and he strideth. From this day forth ask thyself, sinners, ask, Offler strideth. But does he stride for me? Or will you too be cast aside into the great big nasty pit where there shall be a wailing and a gnash of teeth? And if you haven't got teeth, then teeth will be provided. Oh, yes, indeed.
Must be a relative of the guard, because he sounds exactly like Tony Robinson as well.
Black shall be the blood upon his hands, and large, great, piercing things shall be upon his head.
Try again later, or earlier.
And he shall pierce them who holdeth his name in vain.
Oh, there's a fishmonger there. So, there's a shop, fishmonger. And the picture, so we'll take the picture, add that into the luggage. There you go, lovely. Let's have a chat
with
the fishmonger.
Is this fish fresh?
Fresh? Fresh? One of them just made a pass at me wife, sir.
You're a silly man, and I don't think I shall speak with you.
So let's
don't get horribly burned to death by any monsters or anything.
Next, we should come across the barber shop, I think. Ooh, it's a beggar. Hope he's in the Guild of Beggars.
Alms, sir. Alms for the poor.
But I'm already poor.
Whoa. You've got a pointy hat.
That's not wealth, that's status.
Oh, well, spare some status for the poor, Governor.
I think you've got that wrong.
How do you mean wrong? It's a simple request transaction. I underline a need and hope that you, in your wisdom, will provide.
It's not a question of that. It's a question of practicality.
It's not a question of that. It's a question of practicality. Status, by its very nature, is ineffable. As a quality, it is essentially non-transferable.
So are you going to give me status or aren't you?
I can't just give you status. You have to earn it.
For instance?
Reach the top of your profession. Become the most famous beggar in
reach
the city.
Reach the top of your profession.
It's
become
really
the most
odd
famous
that it's now showing subtitles as well.
Real diseases.
Well,
speech.
I'll try. Business is just down a bit. What can I do about it?
You need a more dominating image. Something to demand sympathy. Otherwise, heartless people like me are just going to keep on passing you by.
It's a thought, you know. Yes. Many thanks.
Right, well, let's crack on.
Right, you are then.
Still looking for the barbershop. Didn't see the barbershop. Must be there. There's a door. Oh, there's a woman and there's a barber.
Oh. Well, at least I suppose it's a hair roller. Well, at least I suppose it's a hair roller. Is that a curler in your hair?
Impudent wretch, of course it is.
Just asking. So, it's definitely a roller then.
What?
In your hair. A hair roller.
Well, of course it is. If it wasn't a roller, then why would it be there?
You wouldn't...
Wouldn't what?
You wouldn't say it's a bit unusual at all?
Good heavens, no.
Right, you are then. Yeah. Oh, so you're having your hair set in a traditional style?
Traditional?
With rollers and curls. Oh, yes, it should look very quaint.
Quaint?
Well, a busy woman like yourself can't always be expected to keep up with the new trends.
What? Don't be absurd. Barber, I shall have my hair set straight.
A very wise choice, madam.
Okay, let's talk with Barber.
Hello there.
Hmm? Oh, hello.
Hello.
I suppose it's quite a sensuous sort of job then, playing with women's hair all day.
Oh, not really. Not with the type of women we get in here. No silken locks, no golden magic drifting beneath my scissors. Nothing like my wondrous little milkmaid.
Oh, hello. See, I didn't think he was necessarily straight, the barber, but... he does love the milkmaid. So, whilst he's doing that...
There's a hair roller in there.
I was busy talking to you viewers.
Hello there.
Oh, hello.
I suppose it's quite a sensuous sort of job then, playing with women's hair all day.
Oh, not really. Not with the type of women we get in here. No silken locks, no golden magic drifting beneath my scissors. Nothing like my
wound. I was just distracted by the gorgeousness of the milkmaid. And now if I find his pocket...
There's a hair roller in there. Oh, what are you doing? Get out of my pocket!
Oh, that should have been okay. Okay.
Hello there.
Make him daydream for a third time. I'm really
I suppose it's
sorry
quite a
this.
Sensuous sort of job.
So.
Oh, what are you doing? Get out of my pocket!
Oh.
Hello there.
Oh, hello.
I suppose it's quite a sensuous sort of job then, playing with women's hair all day.
Oh, not really. Not with the type of women we get in here. No silken locks, no golden magic drifting beneath my scissors. Nothing like my wondrous little milkmaid.
I think the medical and hair care profession still have a long way to go.
There's a hair roller in there.
Right, let's leave that for now and crack on. It's warm, we've been okay there, but let's not worry. Right, and so if we exit here, we have to come back and get the... So there's the palace. If we come down south from the palace, there's a square. Let's go to the square. Square. There's an old favourite of ours. Cut me own throat, Dibbler.
Dragon detector, sir.
Hey, what?
Can I interest you in a dragon detector, sir?
Dragon detector.
I'll only charge you cost price, a single shilling. I'm cutting my own throat.
A dragon detector? How does it work?
Easy as pie, sir. This rod has a piece of wood tied to the end. When you get close to a dragon, the wood turns to ash.
How close?
Very well. You caught me there, Governor. A slight design flaw. Tell you what, I'll halve the price. 2 shillings and it's yours. I'm cutting my own throat.
Well, excuse me, I think there's someone calling me.
I'm going to leave him for now. Oh, there's some tomatoes there. So let's grab a tomato. And I think we'll hold that with rinse rinse. There's a street urchin here.
Can't buy a money pouch, sir? Very good, Nick. Cost you 1 shilling.
No, I already have a money pouch, thank you.
Are you sure?
Stolen! The damn thing's been stolen!
Good thing I was at hand with a replacement then, innit, sir?
Wait a minute. This looks exactly like my money pouch.
You see, sir? You'll hardly even know your old pouch is gone. That's service for you.
Now, look. Did you just steal this?
Don't look at me, sir. I'm just a lovable street urchin.
Ooh, it's a mouse.
Urchin?
Yeah, you know, one of them hard things that lives on seaside rocks. The ones that end in points.
It's a starfish, isn't it?
Is it? All right, sir. I'm a lovable street starfish, then.
Sounds a bit fishy to me.
I'm just keen to get you to shell out, Gov.
To shell out. Unbelievable.
Like a second pouch, sir. Just as a reserve, so to speak, in case the worst should happen.
Look, if it's not too much to ask, how did you do that?
What? Give away a trade secret?
Tell me how you do it, or I'll turn your spleen into a tank of sea monkeys.
When you put it that way, Gov, look, it's easy. Just practice on those old guys over there and get your hand in.
Ooh. And so we've managed to steal some trousers.
That doesn't work.
Off of one of the old guys, and that's how we learn the pickpocket skill that we need to get the curler from the barber. Really do have to do things in order with the game. Which is why it takes so long. Right then, if we move our way along, then... Oh! There's a tax collector! And he's in the stocks.
It's pardon? They can't do this to me. I'm the tax collector.
That explains it then.
This isn't funny. I can't believe this.
Oh, I don't know.
Maybe
I find
you should
it
take
funny.
Stock of your situation.
Now listen.
Too bad. Now your reputation's gone to rack and ruin. Still, I suppose it's torture a lesson.
Torture.
Get it?
Get
not
it.
Not a good pun, but then, what is?
Everyone's a comedian. Except you, mister. Help!
What? You're the tax collector, aren't you? What are you doing in there?
Begging without a permit. I asked some old codger for money, and he blew the whistle on me. Next thing you know, they got me in here. This is harassment in the course of duty, I tell you. Let me out of here! They can't do this to me! I'm the tax collector!
Has someone collared your market?
Watch it.
Must be what they call a tax squeeze, innit? Oof, how do I think I'm up?
Very funny. I'll remember you, pencil head. I've a perfect thingy.
Pencil head.
Begins with M. You know, I never forget.
Forget what?
Faces. My business relies on my memory for faces.
They must be your stock in trade.
Right, so as he's a tax collector, what we can do is we did earlier on. Not in there. Rincewind, we gave a tomato to. So let's throw the tomato at the tax collector. That didn't work. Let's go back and get a new tomato. Alright, let's pick up a new tomato. There's that mouse again. we should have on the ground here, behind the luggage. There he is, he's the worm. Let's go and pick up the worm. Place him inside the luggage as well. So we're gathering a lot of things now. So, what else is there? Then we can go further. There's an Amazon warrior. Not talked to yet. Let's talk to her.
Greetings, O noble warrioress.
Greetings, O pointy-hatted elf.
Aye?
It is I, Red Sorcum, chosen avatar of the goddess Mothra. I've come to Ankh-Morpork seeking adventure. I've sworn myself to the quest and may give myself in marriage only to the man who can equal me in combat.
You what? Are you in much demand?
Well, yes, apparently. Under the terms of the Geese, I'm supposed to suffer no insult from any man, which unfortunately includes wolf whistles, lingering looks, and even passing thoughts of attraction, which would be all right, but they insist that I wear this getup. Standard heroine issue. By the way, geese is an archaic word, meaning something like obligations. I really don't want to hear any more jokes about birds.
Inconvenient.
It's ever so cold.
So do many people actually just want to try and marry you?
Oh yes, happens all the time. Well, I suppose I encourage it, really. I mean, it's been 10 years, and a girl has to settle down someday. They've been lining up in the taverns ever since I got here. I've been killing people non-stop since 10:30.
Ah, so, just tell me a bit with this one. In order to get engaged to you, they have to...
Match swords with me, yes.
To the death?
Yes.
Sounds dangerous.
Actually, it's more boring than dangerous. Well, at least from my point of view. Other girls get to debauch with barbarians, and all I get is two-way conversations with the gods.
Really?
Well, it's not as if Mothra, goddess of Stepland, storms, and destroyer of cardboard cities, really has anything much to say. I mean, there's the occasional quest aspect of things, but more often than not, it just means chopping up some mothballs or getting her a nice rug for tea. I suppose there is a lot of posing, and the chainmail bikinis are nice, but it doesn't fill up a Saturday night, if you know what I mean. You, do know what I mean, don't you?
Sure, I know what you mean.
Mothra even gave me this magic sword, said it was to keep me safe. Bitch, every time I meet some halfway likable man, I have to kill him.
Well, can't you stop it?
Well, no, it's a magical curse, you see. For instance, if I even suspected that you found me attractive, I'd be forced to do something really totally unpleasant. Probably involving spleens.
Spleens?
It's an organ. Not sure what it does apart from ooze green.
Well, I understand. Good thing I don't fancy you then, eh?
Oh, I'm ever so pleased. Of course, I feel a lot more comfortable with you in a dress.
If you read Morrison's Educated Rodents, you'll know about everything oozing green.
Goodbye.
Right, let's move on. Don't think that we need to go in there. Can go in here. Oh, we're in the home of the Dunny King. Chickens.
That doesn't work.
Can't do anything with chickens. Don't want to do anything with machines at the moment. Let's see if we can just leave here for now. And here's someone's house. Ah.
Shut up, sit down, no talking. If you're mad, you don't want to run around infecting everybody else.
It's the Persogaiterist's house.
In this world, you cannot stand. Tell me how it makes you feel. Yes, I see. A case of latent aggression, no doubt. Now, I want you to relax and tell me about your innermost feelings. When I say the word in question. Ooh, that's it. Now, monkey.
Said the M word. So that's the cutscene as we enter. Let's talk to the troll.
Egg.
I'm sorry?
The eyes. The awful knowing eyes.
What's happened to you?
I couldn't take it. Thumping, not thumping. My brain's gone potty. Ah! Get them off me. They're all green.
Excuse me, I seem to be in the wrong conversation.
Wibble.
Yes, look, let's not pursue that, shall we?
It's very delicate, you know.
How do you change voices like that?
Change it like what? Minish, Nick.
You did it just then.
It's called bucketing.
Channeling?
No, bucketing. It's like channeling, only it doesn't drain away afterwards. It all just sort of sloshes around in there and dribbles out at random.
The winter evenings must just fly by.
I do have to wonder why a troll would...
This seems like a good cue to cease this whole silly conversation.
So let's leave the building. And now if we go back in, then with luck, the troll's moved.
Shut up, sit down, no talking. If you're mad, you don't want to run around infecting everybody else.
So if we...
That doesn't work.
Shut up, sit... If you...
That doesn't work. Just tools of the trade, I suppose.
Shut up. If you're mad, you don't want to run around infecting everybody else.
So we should now be able to take the butterfly net and leave. So we can leave the square, back past the old men, the old timers. We should now be able to go back to the street, and because we now know how to pickpocket, I'm rather hopeful that we can go into the barbers, talk to the barber.
Hello there.
And now.
Oh, what are you doing? Get out of my
pocket! Pickpocket him. Must be missing something here. Anyhow, let's carry on. We'll go to the stables next, I think. So all that we're really doing at the moment... Oh, there's the shades. Park. Square. There's the stables. All we're doing is walking around at the moment, just gathering stuff that we need. If you were playing the game, you just do this naturally. It's just that I haven't played it before. I know what we need to get. So what we're looking for is a sack there. And out of which we can take some corn. We could talk to the donkey.
But that just doesn't work.
A bit of an ass. So, south of the square, there's a little alley. So what we do need now... Oh! It's an assassin. A member of the Guild of Assassins. Luggage. Should have a mirror in there. Take that out. Let's give that to Rincewind because he'll need that. Ah, that's what I need to get that curler is a pickpocket. So if you walk around here, there's a panel, and if we stay standing on there, we'll get tossed up onto the roof. Okay, so we're at the top. And we should be able to go to the tower, all the way over the back. And as you can see there in the background is the dragon. So if we take the mirror, put the mirror on the tip. It's going to fall off.
A bit slippery, is it?
It's fine, I assure you.
Maybe you'd better just spit on your hands.
That's going to make it even slippier, isn't it?
It might be worth a try.
But then I'll slip and die.
Is that really so bad, philosophically speaking?
It is from where I stand, yes.
Death does have its positive aspects, you know. It's easy to do lying down. Also, have you ever considered the saving on food, rent, and clothing?
Are you saying that this is my appointed time to die?
Well, since you put it like that, no. But I thought, there he is. And I'm happening to be passing, you know. It's a kind of outreach policy.
If it's all the same, I'd rather wait.
Oh, if you insist. I'll see you later.
How much later?
Don't start reading any long books.
Good advice from Death there. So Death has an unusual relationship with Windswind in that Death knows when wizards are meant to die, but Windswind has such a complicated lifetime that Death isn't really sure. So what we should be able to do is, there's the mirror, so if we play around with the mirror, we can probably attract the dragon's attention. Got him. Oh, Clifford.
Ooh, magnificent. Now get out there and slay them.
Oh, and the luggage catches the mirror. So we've now got dragon's breath. So we can go back down. Be able to go back down. Why can't I go back down? Go to the palace. Don't let me off the roof. This is ridiculous.
Yes, yes, a good example of post-dynastic October rock. Oh dear. I think I'm going to be rather ill.
Can't click down on the roofs. Ah, there's the down arrow hand. And down we go. So there's a chimney sweep.
Good morning, Jimmy.
Fine
day for it.
For what?
Well, for whatever innocent folk like we can find to do up here on the rooftop.
Have you ever fallen down?
Oh, yes. Or tons of times.
Well, if you don't want a repeat performance, try shutting up.
Ah, the day is coming when people like you will have to look up to folk like me.
Probably easiest from the ground, then.
What?
Looking up at you, I mean. Probably easiest when done from the ground. Actually, I think I might just get in as little looking up at you right now, in fact. I'll just go down to street level in a quiet, orderly fashion then, shall I?
Mm-hmm. So, let's follow along. Whoa. Oh, there's a ladder. So we'll take that one up. That fell down and got caught by the luggage again. Sign?
That doesn't work.
Can't get anything on the sign. Work our way back along. Goodness me, must be some way down. What I'm really looking for again is the hand pointing downwards.
That doesn't work.
Very odd. They have to spend so much time just working out how to get around.
That doesn't work.
Can't go down the chimney.
Chimneys? Ah, the march of technology is a fine thing.
Very strange. To that window there. Sneaking through the house. That'll do it for us.
Ouch!
I think it plays this same cutscene every time. Just to annoy you. We can always press escape and skip it. Let's not go there. So what we should have here is some sort of fishy house, but it's the alchemist's house. So if we talk to the alchemist.
Eureka! I found it. Finally, it works. My octocellulose has been perfected.
What works?
Nothing. Nothing works at all.
Oh, go on, you were saying something right now.
No, I wasn't.
It was all about octo-something.
Shh! Not so loud. All right, but wizard's oath on this. You have to swear to keep all this a secret.
Oh, all right.
Well?
Well what?
Well, let's hear it then.
It's a secret oath.
I promise I won't listen.
No, that's no good. Tell you what, I'll have to say it in mime. Tell you what, I'll have to say it in mime.
Well, you can't say further than that. Anyway, here before you, you see a new age in entertainment. With my new octocellulose, I'll revolutionize the world. My octocellulose has been perfected.
Eh?
My fortune is made. Moving pictures will soon be the talk of the age.
You've been standing too close to the boiling mercury again, haven't you?
Another Terry Pratchett book mentioned.
Genius has his vice. It helps us to get ahead.
Putting your head in a vice is the best idea you've had all day. Moving pictures, how does it work?
Well, the strips of octocellulose are transparent. When you paint on them and shine light through from behind, it projects a picture onto a wall. You just run the strip through a box filled with gears and springs.
It's a bit noisy.
Ah, The clicking noise is all part of the atmosphere.
What paints the pictures?
There's an imp inside this box. All I do is open up the window and the imp makes the pictures. He paints the frames as fast as I can wind the strips past him.
An imp, eh? Anyway, what are you going to call this new system?
I'm not sure.
Well, it's easy enough. What is their most unique characteristic?
They're moving pictures that click.
Well, there you go. Call them that.
Of course. Clickies. Thank you.
Clickies?
Oh! So, we've got a fireplace there. We happen to have picked up some corn earlier.
That doesn't work.
If we put the corn on the fireplace.
That doesn't work.
Some apparatus. apparatus. More apparatus. I would have thought we were to put the...
That doesn't work.
On there, but we could put it on the flask. That's got some heat on it. That makes Alchemist hide.
Leave the camera alone!
Okay, well, let's go outside. What we can see down here is a little hole. And got a couple of things earlier. We got ourselves earlier some string, and we got ourselves a worm.
That doesn't work.
Just by single clicking on him. Scroll this down, and...
That doesn't work.
Now I've got worm on it.
That doesn't work.
Oh, what did that come outside? All right, is plunk that on Rincewind. Take the string.
That doesn't work.
Well, I'm sure that what I should have now, because it looks
that
like...
That doesn't work.
Stop saying it doesn't work. It does seem to me that that worm has a piece of string on it. So now if I present that to the hole, then I have a little
that
trap.
That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
House mouse, if I'm not mistaken.
You're not mistaken.
That doesn't work.
Very odd, because that does look to me like...
That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Very odd, because it does seem to me that that worm is now on a piece of string.
That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Well, what I might need to do is go back and get the hairdresser's thing first. So if we go back to the street, go in,
hello there. I suppose it's quite...
He's going to think of his girlfriend. We want to get our pickpocket, and now pickpocket his pocket. At which point we should have our curler.
Won't let me do it. Damn! They won't let me do it.
Can I drop that into the luggage?
They won't let me do it.
You thought I could have put the pickpocket in there.
They won't let me do it.
Can't put the pickpocket into
that
the luggage.
That doesn't work.
Into.
Damn! They won't let me do it.
Let's give it back to Rincewind.
that doesn't work. That doesn't...
No.
That doesn't work.
All you keep saying is it doesn't work.
That
I keep
doesn't
not
work.
Pressing it properly. Okay, well. So we could really do with getting the imp. It could just be that we haven't spoken to the alchemist enough. So he's still a bit dazed down there. But the alchemist did tell us about the imp. He just never really asked us to get the imp. So maybe, just maybe, we need to go and talk to the alchemist again.
That doesn't work.
Yeah, it definitely doesn't work, does it?
That doesn't work.
So, back in there.
I have absolutely no desire to talk to that person at this time.
That's a bit odd.
That doesn't work.
Leave the camera.
That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Okay.
That doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't
work. Ah, banged corn. Looks like a little home for a very little creature. Maybe it's a little home. Ah, banged corn. Funny little blighter.
There you go. Now that we try and catch the imp, he runs into the hole. Forgot to release the imp. Now, if we take the worm, we should be able to catch the imp. imp, put the imp back in the bag, in the baggage. So I think we've got just about everything. So what we want to do now is this last couple of things we need before we can go see the Arch Chancellor again. So let's go back to the university. I know a song that will get on your nerves, get on your nerves, get on your nerves. Now, we can either go straight round the back, or we can talk to the chef. The point being is that the chef is cooking pancakes and we can't get the pancakes. So we've gone to all this trouble to
that go doesn't away work
and get a butterfly net from a purse psychiatrist. So we've got that. And then we've got the ladder that we rescued from off the roof. And now we can use the ladder to get up to the window. And now we've got the butterfly net. And you've got to just catch it on the pancake, I think. No, don't do that to me. Come back up the window. I'm obviously not the best in the world at catching pancakes, now am I? To catch the pancake, and that I mean, that's the question, isn't it? Click, click, clickety, click, click. Clicking, left clicking, single clicking, double clicking. Do you think I can catch the pancake? Unbelievable. So, what I'm going to do is sit and try and catch this pancake. Pancake! So I think what we'll do is we'll go down for now and go round and talk to the chef. We shouldn't need to, really, all in all. But do you think I can work out how to catch
that
pancake?
That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Can't go through the door just yet. Let's go across inside, see if we need to talk to the chef first before we can give everything up. So we're going to come down here to the kitchens. There's the cook. And there's his pancake going up.
Excuse me, but could I ask you some questions?
Clear off! And no magic in the kitchen. One more spell goes off in this place, and I'm going
there's
to...
bananas there. Let's have a
Are you always this surly?
Not always. I even know a jolly joke.
Really?
Yes. What's ugly, hollow, and rings like a bell?
I don't know. What?
Look over there.
Did you get the number of that donkey cot?
That's quite funny.
Well, that's a fine skill to have. Your parents must be very proud of you.
Actually, I was going to become a wizard, but they found out my parents were married.
Well, I'll catch
that's
you later then.
That's a bit of a 18 level joke, isn't it? Oh, there's some more bananas. Let's take those later, just because we can. That's handy. Let's go back and see if we can catch these pancakes again this time. See if it will let me catch them now that I've talked to the cook. We've got a ladder. Got a butterfly now. There you go, and as soon as we talk to the cook, I can catch the things. Unbelievable! Unbelievable. But tasty.
Reversing gravity is the last straw. I've had it. I'm off to complain. Spells, wizards, anti-gravity. It's unnatural, that's what it is. So who pays for it, I say? Me, that's who. Up the stairs to complain, then back down to the kitchen. Up and down, like what kids play with on a string.
A kite?
What? Yes, that's the one. Up and down these stairs like a kite.
Well, so, reason for getting the pancake is to get the cook to go away, and the reason to get the cook to go away is that we can get the last part of the dragon detector that we need, which is his frying pan. So let's go across, go to the kitchen. Down to the kitchen. Down to the kitchen. And take the frying pan. Cool, so we should now have all the bits of the dragon detector that we need. So we just need to take all of those up to the Arch Chancellor. So, in terms of what we need to give to the Arch-Chancellor, I'm pretty sure we need to give him some Dragon's Breath.
That's...
I think we need to give him... Frying Pan?
That's good, but off with you, there's still...
Still more to do, so that's 3 out of 5. We need to give him Bim to control the thing.
That's good, but off with you. There's still more work to be done.
Hair roller?
Excellent. Well done, that man. Now that you've finished all the tedious work, all we need is a truly heroic wizard to actually trace the lair and take all of the glory.
Glory. So the Arch-Chancellor now makes the dragon detector. Gold! Or as the...
All right, Breakwind, you may go and try to do something useful around here. No more big dinners for slackers.
Right, well, I'll just... slink off down this corridor, shall I?
Yes, good day, Rincewater.
And you'll handle the gold. I mean, the dragon. You'll just take care of everything.
Yes, quite right.
Perhaps I should volunteer to assist, sir, having had hands-on experience in your actual dragon-locating equipment.
Don't be ridiculous, man. We need someone of character and virility, of strength and guile. Someone, in short, who is not you.
What has 100 eyes, drinks blood, and is bright purple?
Good grief, boy. How should I know?
Well, there's one right behind you, sir. It's not a valuable rug.
So Rincewind takes the dragon detector just that he can detect the dragon. Now. Not too sure where the dragon is. Don't think it's down in the shades. I do know that it's down here somewhere. I thought it was over here. Here. And of course, alright, so we're using the dragon detector at the moment. I can't see it lighting up or anything. I think we might have to do something silly like go to every section of the city before it'll find it. Looked in enough places, then it will suddenly say, oh, there you go. Let's make sure. Go off more over here, doesn't it? Well, I believe I've been just about everywhere on this map now, apart from inside the shades, of course. And that dragon is not to be found with that detector. Ah, there it is. At last.
I'm rich.
Well, you could see
rich.
It. Bigger detector over there.
I'm fabulously wealthy!
Boo-wah-ha-ha!
I'm comfortably well off!
I wonder where shushing is.
It's all mine! and no big, ugly lizard is going to stop me.
Ahem. Ahem. Is that mouse again? Gets everywhere.
However, when I say ugly, I don't, of course, mean lacking in considerable wit, charm, charisma, attractiveness, teeth, claws.
Hush.
Yes, sir. I'm shutting up now, sir.
I am angered, little man. I am angered and I am sorrowful. An evil brotherhood has pulled me from my ancient place of rest and have bent me to their will. I am being used for evil ends. They are inside my head. I cannot stand it. I am not naturally an evil creature. I wish only to return to my home dimension. Seek out this evil brotherhood and destroy the spells that control me, or else they shall force me to kill again. Or else they shall force me to kill again. I cannot fight off their powers
so
much longer.
So important, isn't it, twice?
Ah, yes, well, how do I break this spell?
You must uncover the secret brotherhood. Each of them must own a golden artifact. 6 artifacts used to summon me here. Bring the golden trinkets to me,
so,
and I can sever the brotherhood's control over my mind.
From the secret brotherhood we need to find.
Yes, but where do I find this brotherhood? You said that it was secret.
Seek out the one who stole the Book of Dragon Summoning from the Unseen University Library. He shall lead you to the others.
Well, I suppose I'd better get out and get on with the job then.
Oh, by the way, they really are building me up for a major rampage. If you fail to stop them, you will probably end up gritting down someone's path next winter.
Ah, right. Gotcha.
And that is the end of Act 1 and the start of Act 2. And at that point, I'd just like to say thank you for watching. And I'll be back next time to go through Act 2. Bye!